instant replay. Music news. News you can dance to. Here's Corey James.
Instant replay music news. Here in Atlanta this time, actually we're in the main room of the Lakewood County Fairgrounds, and the band Kansas, on their 10th album, has chosen to record this one in a most unusual way.
Kansas lead guitar player Rich Williams may look like he's in an ordinary recording studio, and producer Neil Kernan certainly appears to be ensconced at the controls of your normal everyday 21st century console, but when drummer Phil Earhart sets up on a tile bathroom, you just know something is strange about the gig. In actuality, Williams and Kernan are inside Les Mobiles, one of the most exotic mobile recording facilities on the road today, which owner Guy Carboneau has parked outside Building 4 of the Lakewood County Fairgrounds here in Atlanta. What's the deal? Well, Carboneau's involvement in mobile recording dates back to 1973, when he worked in live radio concert recording. After building his first truck in 1975, he dreamed of creating an audio super truck.
Basically, this truck being like sort of a drawing board. Every week, every day, basically change things inside, modify, improve. 1977, decide to go bigger. I build this truck, not exactly the way you see it now, but I build with like a gas truck underneath, but the original box is built in 77.
After the experiments panned out, Carboneau found himself with an amazingly versatile machine.
If I need to do like here a studio session, it's really easy, it's no compromise, all the equipment are set up like a real studio. But if you need to do live show as well, the truck is really equipped for that. We just go there and it's easy to interface with PA and sound company. That's the whole idea.
After working with Guy on an MTV shoot and a recorded live radio show, Kansas, then in the middle of rehearsals at the fairground site, decided that it would be a convenient recording facility and that Les Mobiles would make it possible.
And last December or November, they called me and they talking about using the truck to do the album, and they fly me here in Atlanta and they show me the local around, and they said, what do you think? They have like a rehearsal room on this building where they normally rehearse, and they've been ready to improve or modify the building. And I said, could we see the other building? Could we check for different place? He said, yeah, all these buildings here on the fairground could be used. And what we did is just like I go with them and visit every room, and suddenly I saw this building where it's like a huge room inside. It's like a, you know, with a stage as well. It's like, I don't know how many room upstairs, you know, like 10 different size and room. And I said, geez, that's the place. You could be here, you could hang out on this room, put a TV set there if you want, and the people not working could sit there. But you have all the other room to, you know, could record around there, you could use the stage, you could use the big room.
And the bathroom. With a nearly infinite variety of sounds available in the vast expanses of the fairgrounds buildings, producer Kernan found that the more traditional sounding rooms were almost never used.
Yeah, we've got rooms upstairs which are almost as dead as a studio, not quite as intensely dead, but very well, sort of, you know, well sort of sectioned off. We haven't really used them much. We've been using bright live rooms or very live rooms for percussion and stuff like that. What we're doing, we're kind of cutting out the guesswork and sort of saying what often happens in mixing is in an attitude to recording is, well, there's no problem. We'll record it straight and we'll fix it in the mix. We'll do it like that, you know, we'll play safe. We haven't been playing safe. We've been going for the sound that we want when we actually put the track down.
You all set?
Yeah.
There's a hole in the world where the light's shining in, and it's letting me know to get up. It's time to begin. Oh, there's nothing to lose, 'cause it's already lost in a runaway world of confusion. I'm not gonna take it.
Instant Replay dropped in on Kansas, recording their 10th album at the Lakewood County Fairgrounds in Atlanta. A guided tour of the facility revealed 33,000 square feet of recording and lounging space, and the remote technology of Les Mobiles, state-of-the-art in mobile recording. Kansas drummer Phil Earhart expressed his newfound enthusiasm.
First time in a major bathroom, yes. Playing drums in a bathroom anyway, yeah. After 10 albums, you could look at it, well, we're doing just another album, and we're trying to break that train of thought, because you do get into the same studio, the same place, with the same people, album after album after album. People just go, well, I know what that album's going to sound like. It's going to sound like the last four or five albums. So we've just had a completely different turnaround and a different outlook on this album, coming to a place that where an album has never been recorded before, and doing it with probably the finest mobile truck in the world. Yeah, it's added a lot of excitement, a lot of newness to the songs, and I think the people are going to hear the difference in not only the sound, but in the performance itself.
Kansas guitar player and charter member Rich Williams thinks the passage of time has actually created new opportunity for the band.
Back in the good old days, when we did sell a lot more records, well, a lot of those people now are dentists and doctors and grown up, and they probably don't listen that much, so those fans have kind of moved on, and there's a different listening audience now. So in a way, although there still are some hardcore fans, it's kind of just by the passage of time, it gives us a chance to, we don't have to stick to any old format that we once had done. So it's a little bit of pressure, but it's more excitement and exciting to try something else than feeling any pressure by it.
In another room, singer-songwriter John Elefante, the newest and at 25, the youngest member of Kansas, commented on the new Kansas sound.
There's more air in the music. It seems like it's a trend nowadays to have a little more of an airy sound as opposed to a really layered, cluttered sound of the 70s, with a lot of synthesizers and a lot of vocals filling up all the holes. Just some good, solid rock tunes that I think are going to be accepted pretty well.